So I will be discussing here chapter 4, chapter 4 in structural theory 1 is arches and cables. So for this will be the first part of the chapter, analysis of arches. As you can see here, I will be discussing analysis of arches followed by analysis of cables. So unahin muna natin yung arches, okay? So after the careful study of this chapter, you should be able to do the following. Number one is to identify the different parts and types of arches. Analyze the 3-inch arches. So yun lang yung i-analyze natin. Identify the different types and applications of cables. Analyze cables with concentrated loads. And finally, analyze cables with distributed loads. So let us now begin with the analysis of arches. So what is meant by arches? So arches are used to reduce the bending moments in long span structures. So ginagamit ito kapag yung beam is sobra ng haba, so as to reduce the bending moment on such structures, ginagamitan na tanang ng arches. Okay? So arches is actually just an inverted cable. Okay? So yung cable ay ganito. Sorry. So yung cable ay ganito yung itsura. So yung arches naman ay pabaliktad, inverted lang siya. And the loads in arches are mainly in compression. Okay? Unlike sa cable, they are mainly in tension. So let us now go to the different parts ng cables. So first here is the abutment. So yung abutment ay kung saan nakapatong yung arch. Okay? So after the abutment is the spring line, ito yung support ng arch. And the back, itong part na to, yung back ng arch is the tinatawag na extra dos. And yung soffit naman is ito, yung sa ilalim nung extra dos is the intrados or the soffit. And the highest point here is the crown, yung tinatawag na crown. And meron ditong hunch. Ito yung hunch niya, yung part na to. And of course, the center line is here. Okay? So there are different types of arches. Number one is the fixed arch. So they are open made from reinforced concrete kapag fixed arch. So marami naman tayo nakikita ng ganyan. So they must have solid foundation abutments. So solid daw ito dapat. So solid to, hindi nagsasettle. And of course, they are indeterminate to the third degree. So third degree yung indeterminacy niya. So we could not solve it dito sa theory 1 kasi hanggang determinate lang tayo. Okay? Bakit third degree? From your previous topic, previous chapter. So meron kasi, dahil fix ito, merong tatlong reactions, okay? Meron ding tatlong reactions dito. Overall, they are 6 reactions here, and we have only 3 equations na pwedeng gamitin. So ibig sabihin may tatlong kailangan pa na equation. So ibig sabihin the indeterminacy of this structure is to the third degree. So here, 2-inch arc, they are commonly made from metal or timber. So they are indeterminate to the first degree. Bakit first degree? As you can see, dalawang hinge yan. So ibig sabihin, kapag hinge, merong Y tsaka X reactions. So merong dalawang reactions dito, dalawang reactions yan. Overall, merong 4 reactions. They are only 3 available equations. So ibig sabihin, merong 1 na degree of indeterminacy. Kakailanganin mo pa ng isang equation to solve such problems or such structures. So the 3-inch arc naman, ito yung i-analyze natin later on. They are made from metal or timber. So they are statically determinate. Why? This is an example of a 3-inch arc. Here, merong Nasaan ba ang ano dyan? So, hinge yan. So, ibig sabihin may dalawa na reactions. May dalawa dito. Tapos, merong isa dito na hinge. So, ibig sabihin magkakaroon ka ng isa pang equation. Yung tinatawag na equation of condition. Kasi naka-hinge. Merong hinge dyan. Sa banda dyan. Okay? So, ibig sabihin. So, 4 reactions minus 3 available equations. 3 equilibrium equations. Equilibrium equations plus 1 na equation of condition, equation of condition. So equation of condition. Okay, so overall, so 0. Okay, 0 yung ano natin, ibig sabihin this is determinate. Okay, so tide arc. So yung tide arc naman, they are supports, the supports are connected with a tie rod. So ito yung tie rod. So take note, naka roller to. So kung naka roller yan, naka hinge to. So determinate pa rin yan. So yung tie rod, dahil tinanggal mo yung sa pin, kunwari pin yan para stable, yung tie rod naman ang magre-resist ng horizontal component of the forces. Okay? So they are unaffected by relative settlement of the supports. Let us now go to the analysis of three hinge arcs. Sabi ko nga ito yung, take note, this is a determinate structure. Determinate structure. So paano ba ina-analyze yan? First of all, hinahati-hati yung arch. Okay? So ang unang ginagawa diyan is, so alam natin na merong, kung A yan, merong AY, may ganyan na reaction na AX dito sa B, may, I can call it BX, at merong BY. Okay? If I will some moment here, dahil same elevation naman yung naka-drawing dito, if I will some moment here, walang moment yung BX of course. Makukuha ko ngayon yung BY. Okay? And then, I will some forces along the Y direction, makukuha ko yung AY. Paano kuhanin yung AX? Of course, I cannot sum AX and BX. I cannot sum forces along the X. Dalawa yung unknown pa, yung AX saka BX. So, ang ginagawa dyan is hinahati yan. So, ang nangyayari dyan is, kung meron akong ganito, ngayon pwede akong makasuratan. So, glue ganito natin. Yan. Okay? So, kung meron akong ganyan, so, assuming ito yung so, if this is A and this is C, of course, here sa A, naka-pin support naman yan. So, ibig sabihin, meron kang AY, meron kang AX. Sa C na to, hinge naman yan, merong shear and axial load dyan. So, merong kang CY, merong kang CX. Okay? So, dyan yung force P. If I will some moment here, of course, walang moment yung dalawang yan, known naman na to, then I can solve for AX. Okay? Kasi may moment arm naman yan. This will be the moment arm ng AX. Moment arm for AX. Okay? So ito yung binabanggit dyan. Yan yung sinasabi dito. Okay? Yan yung sinasabi dyan. Pero what is this? So, if I will cut here, ang kakaroon ako ng ganyan. So, dahil hindi naman hinge itong nagkatan ko, so, meron kang, so, sabihin natin this is D. So, this is D. merong kang DY, merong kang DX, and dahil hindi yan hinge, merong moment dyan na D. Okay, take note, kapag hinge, walang moment. Claro? So, what's next? So, let us try to solve. So, I hope naintindihan nyo kung anong sinasabi dito, ah. So, kung ano yung sinasabi dito. I hope nagkakaintindihan tayo. Then, we will try to solve the first problem here, that the tied 3 hinge arc is subjected to the loading. Shown, determine the components of the reaction at A. So, yung anong dito ay reaction at A. Hala, sorry. The reaction at A. Okay. Ay, components pala yung reaction na tayo. So, ibig sabihin, AX and AY. And the reaction at C. So, reaction at C. So, take note, this is roller. So, kung roller yan, sa reaction at C, yung unknown lang dyan is yung AY. And the tension at A, at the cable. So, sabihin natin, just tension. Okay? So, first of all, here is to draw the free body diagram. So, the free body diagram for that arc. So, ganyan yan. Yan. So, this is point B, hinge, the hinge part. This is naka-hinge din, A. And this one is point C, merong tie rod dito. Okay, what are the reactions? Merong AY, merong AX, and this one is CY. Dahil roller lang yan, it cannot resist horizontal forces. Okay, and the forces, the loads, this is 15 kilonewtons. This one is 10 kilonewtons. And for the dimensions, distances. So for the distances, ito yung mga distances natin. So this is 0.5. Sensya na, hindi to scaled. This is 2 meters, 1 meter, and another distance is this one. This is 2 meters. First of all, to solve for a reaction here, I can sum moment at point A to solve for CY. Summation ng moment at A is equal to 0. Letting counterclock to be positive, what are those moments? CY with moment arm 1 plus 2 3 5 5.5. Then itong 15 kilonewtons will tend to rotate the arc clockwise, in a clockwise rotation, so dapat negative yan. Kasi take note, may convention, counterclockwise yung positive. So, times 15, moment arm will be 0.5 minus 10 times the moment arm is 4 plus 0.5, 4.5 is equal to 0. So, I can now compute CY, so you can use your calculators, but pwede kong silipin dito yung sagot. Yung CY is 9.55 kilonewtons. Take note, positive naman yung sagot natin. So, we are correct dun sa direction natin dito. Okay? So, yung assumption natin na upward yan, correct yan. So, ibig sabihin, CY is indeed upward. So, what else? Summation of forces along Y is equal to 0. Okay? So, summation of Fy is equal to 0. So, for this, that would be AY plus CY, which happens to be 9.55. Take note, positive yung upward natin, yung assumption natin. Minus 15 minus 10 kilonewtons is equal to 0. AY then is equal to, AY is 15.45 kilonewtons. So, positive naman yung naging sagot natin dito. So, dahil dyan, upward yung AY. And then, summation of Fx for the whole structure is equal to 0, letting pi toward to be positive. So, Ax, meron pa ba? Wala naman ng horizontal force. So, Ax is equal to 0. Okay? So, paano? Meron na akong CY, meron na akong AX, meron na akong AY. So, yun yung mga tinatanong. Kaso nga lang, yung last na pinapahanap is, determine the tension in the cable. Determine the tension in the cable. So, paano yan? So, by consider the AB part. Okay? Considering AB, the part AB. So, ganito yung itsura ng AB. So, this is point B. This is point A. So, take note, hinge parehas yan. So, sa B, merong BY. Sa C, sa horizontal, merong BX. Take note, dahil hinge yan, wala naman yung moment. So, dito, merong AY, which happens to be, ano yung AY natin? Yung AY natin is 15.45. 15.45 kilonewtons. Meron ding AX happens to be equal to 0. And aside from that, meron dito tension. The tension in the cable. So, hinatikasin natin yan. And of course, meron dito rin yung applied load, which is 15 kilonewtons. Okay? And what are the distances here? So, the distances are 0.5 meters, 2 meters, meron ding distance ito. It happens to be 2 meters. Okay? So, now, by analyzing this part ng arc, I can sum moment here such that makuha ko yung tension na yan. Ganun lang kasimple yan. Nagsamak mo yung moment dito yung A, of course, unknown yung BY, unknown yung BX. So, it's not practical to sum moment at A. Okay? Pwede rin namang mag-sum ng forces na lang. Okay? Kung mag-sum ng forces, yung AY, and I know, makukuha mo yung BY. Pero ang hinahanap ko dito is yung tension T. So, the best practical way here is to sum moment at B, which is equal to 0. Okay? Hello. Sorry. So, sum moment at B is equal to 0. Summation of moment at B is equal to 0. Letting counterclockwise. So, kahit ano, clockwise or counterclockwise yung gusto nyo, wala namang problema dyan. So, summing moment here, so, ano ba yung mga, ito, magka-counterclock yan. Tama ba? Counterclock yung moment niya. So, that would be 15 times 2 meters. How about this tension? So, counterclock din yan. Plus T times 2 meters din. Then, yung AX, 0 naman. Yung AY will be clockwise rotation. Minus 15.45 times the moment arm is 2.5 is equal to 0. I can now solve for the value of T. What is the value of T? So, you can use your calculators or silipin na lang natin dito. T is equal to 4.31 kilonewtons. Of course, tension yan. You don't need to write kastoy, uno kasta, tension yan. Take note, pag tensile member, parating always away from the member. So that is tension and tension. Okay? So next, we will be solving the second problem here. So I had prepared 3 problems, I think. So mukha lang tong mahirap. Diyak maka next page. So for the next problem here, problem number 2, determine the resultant forces at the pins A, yung pin ito, pin A, pin C, pins A, B, and C, kung ano, yan, yan data. Okay, so they are hinges. So paano yung first step dyan? The first step is to draw the FBD of the whole structure. So drawing lang natin. Ayan. So that is the FBD of the whole. This will be the FBD of the whole structure. Merong tatlong hinges dito. So ano yung mga yan? The A, B, and C. And what are the forces? So may tatlong force dito. Not scale na lang. To scale, at merong forces dito banda, dalawa din. So 2, 3, 4, 2 kilonewtons, 3 kilonewtons, and 4 kilonewtons. This is 4 kilonewtons and 5 kilonewtons. And how about the distances, mamaya na? So this will be AY. This will be AX. Ito yung CY. Ito yung CX. And for the distances here, yeah, I've said hindi ito nakascale. Okay. Maganda rin na i-observe yung scaling kapag nagsasolve ng ganito. And what are the distances? Horizontal distances, 3 meters, 1 meter, 1 meter, 3 meters, 2 meters, 3 meters, and 2 meters. And what else? Data. So this is 5 meters. Okay? So, ano muna natin gagawin? I would try to solve for AY here. So, I will sum moment, CY na lang. Moment at A is equal to 0. Letting counterclockwise to be positive. So, moment at A. So, yung CY tends to rotate the structure in a counterclockwise direction. So, CY 3, 4, 5, 8, 10, 15. 4, 5, 8. Tama. So CY times 15 nga ba yan? Yes, CY times 15. Then yung CX magkabatog damat lang, so walang moment yung CX. And then this 5 vertical loads here downward will tend to rotate the structure in counterclockwise, so negative dapat yan. 2 times 3 minus 3 times 4 minus 4 times 3 plus 1 plus 1 is 5 minus another 4, 3 plus 1 is 4, 5, 8 plus 2, 10, and minus 5 times 13. Tama ba? So I can solve for CY. So tingnan na lang natin dito yung CY. That is 9.53 kilonewtons. Positive yung sagot dito, so upward. Okay? Summation of Fy, considering also the whole structure, is equal to 0. So what are those forces? Ay plus Cy, which happens to be 9.53. Okay? 9.53 minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 4, minus 5 is equal to 0. Ay happens to be 8.47 kilonewtons. Positive yung naging sagot ko, so ibig sabihin upward. Okay, so meron na akong Ay tsaka Cy. Next, I will consider AB. This is B. This is A. Ano yung nakuha natin? Ay. What is Ay? Ay is equal to 8.47 kilonewtons. 8.47 kilonewtons. Unknown pa rin yung AX. Of course, dahil hinge ito, na-expose na, ma-expose na ngayon yung BY. Nag-cut tayo kasi dito. At saka BX. And the forces, tatlong forces yan. 2 kilonewtons. Three kilonewtons and 4 kilonewtons. And for the distances, magbabago yung distances dito. This is 3 meters pala. 3 meters, 1 meter, 1 meter, and 3 meters. And of course, this one is 5 meters. Okay. So, what to do next here is to some moment here to eliminate BX and BY, makukuha ko yung AX. So that is the best and the practical way to do to solve this problem. So summation of moment sa B is equal to 0. Counter clock ulit ang gusto kong positive. So yung AX ay merong tend to rotate the structure in a counterclockwise direction. AX times 5. Yung AY is negative. 8.47 times 3458. So how about this vertical loads? So positive yan, counter clock yung ibibigay nilang rotation. 2 times 5 plus 3 times 4 plus 4 times 3 is equal to 0. Yung AX happens to be equal, using your calculators of course, yung AX natin is 6.75 kilonewtons. And it is positive, so directed to the right. Okay, considering again that AB, I can sum forces along X is equal to 0, letting rightward forces to be positive. So what are those forces? Yung AX, which happens to be 6.75, minus BX is equal to 0. Therefore, BX is equal to 6.75 kilonewtons. Positive naman yung sagot natin. So, tama yung assumption natin na to the left yan. And another one, summation of Fy is equal to 0, letting upward forces to be positive. So, what are those forces? 8.47, the Ay plus BY. Okay? BY pa. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 is equal to 0. BY is equal to, what is BY? BY is equal to 0.53. So that would be 0.53 kilonewtons. And this one, that is upward. So now for the last part, consider segment BC. So for BC, so ganito yan. So this is point B, this is point C. Merong dalawang forces dito, 4 and 5. So merong CY happens to be 9.53, and merong CX, plus merong BY na pababa. Ano yung BY natin? Manipata ko. BY is 0.53 kilonewtons, and BX is equal to 6.75. Tingnan natin, pabaliktad lang yung mga yan sa doon sa kabilang structure. That's according to Newton's third law of motion. And then so no need naman na siguro ito 3 meters, 1 meter, 1 meter. Ngayon, kurang. Tabali man, tagit kita akon. 2, 3, 2. So, 2 meters, 3 meters, and 2 meters. And of course, this one is 5 meters. Although hindi importante ito kasi ang balak ko dyan is just simply sum forces along X is equal to 0. Okay? So, summing forces along X, so that would be BX minus CX. BX happens to be known na. Okay? So, BX is 6.75 minus CX is equal to 0. Cx is then equal to 6.75 kilonewtons, and happens to be to the left. Okay, let us summarize. So, summarize natin yung Ax, Ay, Bx, By, Cx, Cy. Yung Cx is 6.75 kilonewtons. Ganyan. Yung CY is 9.53 kilonewtons. Nga pataas. Yung BX is 6.75 kilonewtons. Dalawa tong direction nito, ah, depende kung anong structure yung structure na i-consider. And yung BY is 0.53 kilonewtons. Yung AY is 8.47 kilonewtons, at yung AX ay 6.75 kilonewtons. Knowing all this, hindi naman ito yung tinatanong kasi ang sinasabi dyan, the resultant. Sabi dito sa problem is the resultant forces. Okay? So kung resultant forces ang tinatanong, so yung RA, sasabihin natin yung FA. Sige, RA na. RA is simply equal to AX squared plus AY squared. So this is equal to the AX natin, 6.75. Square root of 6.75 squared plus yung AY natin is 8.47. 8.47 square. So RA equals 10.83 kilonewtons. So ito yung isa sa mga tinatanong. Next is RC. RC is simply equal to CX squared plus CY squared. So this is equal to the square root of CY. CY is 6.75 squared plus, and CY is 9.53 plus 9.53 squared. So RC then is equal to, RC is 11.68 kilonewtons. If you are asked to determine the direction of this, so pwede mo namang kuhanin, pero hindi ko nagagawin ha. So ang gagawin nyo lang dyan is, ayan. Alright, what is the direction of AX? Direction of AX is going to the, ayan. AX is going kasta, AY is upward. Correct? So ang gagawin mo dyan is, paplat mo lang, paganto yung AX, pataas daw yung AY. So the resultant here is this one. Let it be resultant. Ito yung RA. Hanapin mo lang yung angle na theta na yan. Okay? Yung paano yan? Tangent theta is equal to AY over AX. So ang mangyayari dyan, no, kaya't mong agda-direction na theta, dudugtungan mo yan ng ganda. Ayan, kasi yan. Tapos, kung ano yung theta na masasolve mo. Okay? How about yung force at the internal hinge B? So, FB is equal to the square root of BX squared plus BY squared. So, this is equal to the square root of BX tayo, 6.75. 6.75 squared plus 0.53 ba yung BY? 0.53 yung BY plus 0.53 is equal to 6.77 kilonewtons. So that would be FB. Okay? So yan yung resultants. RA, RC, and FB. Okay, continuing for the last problem in arches. The three hinge arc here, the three hinge spandrel arc is subjected to the loading shown. Determine the internal moment in the arc at point D. So dito pinapahanap yung moment dyan. Okay? Okay. So, paano yan? So, drawing lang natin alit. So, for the FBD, FBD ng arc, so, pwede kong simplify na ganito na lang yan. Yan, same elevation. So, there, merong dami namang forces. Merong force dito. Apat. Yan. Then, meron ding apat. Yan. Andi dito yung internal hinge. That is B. That ito ay A. That ito ay C. So, mamaya na, yung D daw yung pinapahanap. Kuhanin ko muna yung mga reactions. Specifically, reaction lang sa A kasi kakonsider ko mamaya yung AB. So, 4 kilonewtons, 8 kilonewtons, 8 kilonewtons, 4 kilonewtons, 3 kilonewtons, 6, and 3 kilonewtons. Here. So, what are the dimensions? Ay, meron pang forces. Ay, yung mga reactions. So, this will be AY. this will be AX, CY, and CX. And for the dimensions here, so isahin natin. Dami. Yan. Two meters yung mga distances ng bawat loads there. So 2 meters din dito. 2 meters. Paano yan? Yung sa gitna. So paano kayo nakuha yan? Matay. So the whole thing is actually 8 plus 5 plus 3. So that is 16 meters. So mana dito yan? 2, 4, 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. 16, so meron pang natitirang 4, so tag 2 meters yan. So 2 meters lahat yan. Okay? And this one is, okay, so that one is 5 meters. So 5 meters yan. So paano ko kukuhanin yung AY or AX? So ang unang kong kukunin dyan is yung AY by summing moments at C. Summation ng moment sa C equal to 0, letting counterclock ulit. So walang moment yung AX, same level lang kasi sila. So dito forces the counterclockwise the moments na. So 4 times 16 minus 2 is 14 plus 8 times, ay mali, sorry, this is 16 plus 8 times 14 plus 8 times 12 plus 4, 12 minus 10 plus 3 times 2, 4, 6 6 plus 6 times 4 plus 6 times 2 plus 3 times 0 plus 0. No. So meron pang plus AY or minus AY rather. Minus AY times 16 is equal to 0. And solving for AY, AY is equal to 22.88 kilometers. Okay, so problema ko yung AX kasi ang pinapahanap dyan is sa point D. Merong point D dito kung saan ang distance niya ay ito. Distance niya, that is 3 meters. Again, 3 meters. Again, 3 meters. Okay? So, yun yung pinapahanap. So, alamin ko lang yung AX and AY. Then, magkakat ako dito. Dito mismo. So, masasolve ko na yan. Okay? So, paano ko hahanapin yung AX? Hindi naman ako pwedeng mag-sum ng forces. So, ang gagawin natin ay consider AB. Consider AB muna. Yan. This is point B. This is point A. AY. Nahanap na natin yung AY is 22.88. 22.88 kilonewtons mayroong AX. Of course, may expose na dito yung BY tsaka BX. Other forces, may force dito. Apat. 4884. 4 kilonewtons, 8 kilonewtons, 8 kilonewtons, and 4 kilonewtons. So distances are 2 lahat. 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters, and this one is 5 meters. Then I would like to sum moment at B para masolve ko yung AX na to. It's equal to 0. So AX times 5, okay, minus 22.88 times 2468, then plus 4 data, 4 nga data, times 8 plus 8 times 6, 246 plus 4, 8 times 4 plus 4 times 2 is equal to 0. I can now solve for AX. Ang AX natin ay 12.61 kilonewtons, and it is indeed going to the right. So andito yung point D. Now I will consider segment AD. So ano yung tsura ng segment AD? Kasta, if this is point D, this is point A. So meron akong AY. Ano yung AY natin? Ang AY natin ay 22.88 kilonewtons upward, tapos may AX tayo na nandito lang yung AX, 12.61 na right, 12.61 kilonewtons. So meron ditong of course DY, DX, and of course yung hinahanap na MD. And the forces sa D, manong forces included yan, dalawa lang. So that is 4 kilonewtons can 8 kilonewtons. Sakbay dayjay point D. So what are the distances here? This is 2 meters. And from that 8 kilonewtons up to that D, that is only 1 meter kasi 3 meters lang yung total. And this one is 3 meters also. So okay, in order to solve for that moment at D, I would like to sum moment at D. Letting counterclock to be positive. Okay, so counterclock yung assumption ko dyan, so positive yung MD. Wala namang moment yung DX tsaka DY. Ito na, unahin ko na ito. So, yung 12.61 is positive. 12.61 times what would be the moment arm? It's 3 meters. Then that 22.88 is a negative moment. 22.88 times 3. And 4 kilonewtons is a positive moment. 4 times 3. That 8 is positive also. 8 times 1 is equal to 0, and MD happens to be, using your calculators, MD is equal to positive 10.81 kilonewton meter. So ibig sabihin kapag positive, it is katulad nito, katulad ng convention ko, which is counterclock. And that ends for the cable. So the next part will be That ends for the arches. The next part is for the cable.